We've got our classic harbor hustler. Every harbor you go to in a country like this, there's always the guy that looks after the yachts.
The fixer.
But it's cool, because he'll probably come over and be like, welcome, what do you need? Do you need customs, immigration? He'll probably tell us the process.
See if he speaks English first off.
Hello! C'est bon?
Parlez-vous l'anglais?
Non, moi je parle pas anglais.
Non, non anglais.
Parle que français, malgache. Moi dans l'autre bateau là-bas.
Ah, you work on that one?
Oui.
Oh man. Brian.
Sergio.
Nice to meet you, Sergio.
My name's Sergio.
Photo, c'est bon?
C'est bon.
Ok.
No problem.
Je m'appelle Brady.
Brady.
Oui.
Tu veux un beer?
No problem.
No?
C'est bon. Oui, c'est
okay.
Bon.
Okay.
I drink a beer.
Yeah.
Sergio.
Sergio the fixer.
And we're meeting up with him tomorrow.
Yeah, we'll go see him in the morning. Easy as.
Previously on Delos.
We are picking up anchor and should have a fast and pretty intense sail to Madagascar, I think. It's gonna be a lot of wind and a lot of waves.
Got some dolphins.
What's the plan?
We gotta go check in. Go pick up Sergio, our mate. And we'll go check in to Madagascar.
Let's do it. Let's go, huh?
Hey, you know. Good luck.
Oh, excuse me.
Hey, nice necklace. The guitar. Silver guitar. I like it.
You play.
So everybody's gone in to check in, and I'm left here on the boat because I'm feeling like shit so bad. Last night I think I got the sickness that everybody has had been having, so hopefully I'll be able to eat something soon and start exploring a lot about. But for now, I'm going back to sleep.
So, the customs guys were super nice. The Coast Guard was super cool. And hopefully, immigration dudes will be just as nice. We're going to try and get 3 months stay, I think. See if we can do that. Maybe I should ask for 4 months, see what they say.
Yeah.
How do you say month?
I don't think I've ever seen anybody use them.
Me neither.
The Cypress.
Yeah.
So, we're done. We're checked in, we're official, we got 90 days.
Yeah.
So we're sorted.
Checked in for 3 months.
Cool. Alright.
Let's go find some Zebu.
Yeah.
Camille's first Madagascan zebu.
What do you think about that?
It's so good. I'm probably gonna get really sick, but like right now I feel like it's gonna be worth it.
We left Madagascar nearly a year ago, and now, after some 6,000 nautical miles of sailing, we are finally back. And it felt incredible.
Merci,
too.
Making some explorer sandwiches.
Brady's been watching this crazy documentary.
Pirates set up what became known as Pirate Island. There's nothing like this in the world. You've got five pirate ships within 200 or 300 feet from shore. Barry thinks one of the five wrecks is...
That's where we are.
Delos is anchored here. And there's five pirate ships here.
And he now knows all about the pirates in the area. So we're gonna go pirate exploring today.
We don't need to go looking for pirates, we've got one right out here. Look at this guy.
What's up?
He's like a modern pirate. He's got one still while editing videos.
Well, after this batch is done, we're gonna go find Pirate Island, bro. There's a lot of pirates, pirate themes around here. And apparently Captain Kidd and a couple other really famous pirates called this place home back in like the 1700s. So there's an island there that they call Pirate Island where they set up base camp. And apparently there's some treasure buried. We're gonna go find it.
It's gonna be a close call, but we're betting that it's high tide now, so that if we can make it under it, we don't get stuck on the other side. Here we go. Watch your heads.
Ah!
Got it.
Oh, hello.
Yeah, it's pretty high tide.
Where is it, Brady?
We have Pirate Island, which is apparently where Captain Kidd buried his treasure on land. There's a massive anomaly underground. There's this point over here where all the pirates were buried after they died. Somewhere over there, we don't really know, but somebody will know.
I think I see something on the top of the hill. It looks promising. Stand by, everybody, coming in.
Come in hot, come in hot.
We've sent our best scout on a recon mission to see if it's safe for our little feetsies.
Yeah, Brady, we're gonna go check out the other side.
So we're getting guided by this awesome fisherman. What a nice man. Look at that trail, huh?
How excited are you?
Really excited. It's gonna be awesome.
Is it nice up there? Yes?
No problem.
No problem.
Meanwhile, Brady took the hard way. It's eerie here. Very eerie. So Brady, can you tell us a little facts about this place?
Well, legend has it that it is the world's only pirate cemetery. And this is quoting the historian Barry Clifford. there was so much pirate activity back in the days of the pirates. What was it, like the 1700s, 1800s, around that time?
17th century,
so 1600s. But this was like the main point besides the Caribbean for pirates around the world was Madagascar and this area. And they'd capture boats that were coming down from like Goa and from India, going around the bottom of Africa and up into Europe. So this, they would all hang out around here. And then they go out and they get their treasures.
Snatch.
Yeah, and this is a cemetery. And apparently, Captain Kidd is buried here, standing in an upright position. Although, he was hung in New York, so...
Which doesn't make any sense.
Doesn't make any sense, but...
He was hung in Boston.
Oh, Boston. Mm. He's hung in the States, but... There's supposed to be a tomb here where he's standing to pay for his sins. He doesn't get to lay down when he's dead. Let's go check it out and see what we can find.
Night
this, man. Old school graves.
What does it say?
This one was, it looks like 1802.
Guys, you're not gonna believe this.
That is the star from the Stone Templars. That's their symbol.
Really?
Yeah. The one. Captain Kidd is standing vertical inside there.
Is this the one?
Apparently. According to local folklore and legend, this is where Captain Kidd is upright. Because he didn't deserve to be buried laying down because he was such a terrible person at the end of his life. Oh shit! Come check this out, guys. It looks like a very happy skull with little bits of semen. This is so cool, man. You pretty never cool, get to see stuff like this.
Yeah.
And it's pretty, I don't know, it's pretty legitimate, I think. This is at the top of this random hill. And the graves are so old. I think the youngest one we've seen so far is from 1877. And a lot of these you have no idea because all the markings are just
gone.
You can't even read them anymore. Do you guys want to go check out Pirate Island? This is the Pirate Island. And this is where Captain Kidd apparently hid his treasure. He brought it on the island after he stole it from another pirate named Le Bouze, who stole it from the Knights Templar in Goa.
Who stole it from the Indians.
But it's apparently it's a, what's it called? The Flaming Cross of Goa. It's a solid gold cross encrusted with precious jewels. And it's buried somewhere on this island.
That looks like treasure collecting material.
I'm gonna hop off and get you guys coming in, eh?
So we're just walking, looking for things. Camilla has found a tree. What did you guys find? What is this?
It's not a natural hole. We found more holes.
People have definitely been digging it.
That is funny. So funny.
Yeah, this has to be where somebody thinks treasure is. Maybe they tried up there first and then they decided down here was better. I don't know. But there's definitely a lot of fresh holes around here.
Look at that.
And they're definitely man-made too.
It's pretty interesting that people actually have been digging here, you know? Like, huge holes to look for this treasure.
Feels like you're in a real adventure. Because when he was hung, or when Captain Kidd was hung, he had a rolled up piece of paper in his hand and he threw it out into the crowd. And it was like a scroll that had the secret code on it for where his treasure was buried. And it's cool to see holes, it's cool to see actual evidence that other people believe that there's treasure here. Or maybe there was and they found it and they like...
Yeah, you snatched it up.
They snatched it up, and of course if you tell anybody then government's on you and it's a war of who actually owns it and who it belongs to.
Yeah.
But it's definitely sweet.
Alright, so we've been in this cool little anchorage in the main town in I'll say Marie for a few days now, and we're checking the weather and we see this beast out here and it's headed directly for I'll say Marie. Yeah. So that's 40. So that's 40, which means gusts into the 50s probably.
Ooh.
As it comes closer to us, it turns the wind from southeasterly to southerly. And then as it gets right close to the island, it even goes slightly westerly for a little while. It's not, doesn't last very long. It goes light pretty quickly, but we are actually anchored right about here because we can't get any further in right here. We're protected from like easterly, southeasterly, southerlies, but any component of westerly, we're a little bit exposed. So our plan is to pull up the hook and we're gonna run up the coast straight to here and see if we can tuck in maybe somewhere in here. According to the chart, we should be able to get in here, which will give us better protection from swells coming from the west. It'll still be windy, but I think it'll be a little bit better protected. So I think we'll pull up the hook and move up here.
Running from the beast.
An estimated 2,000 to 3,000 humpback whales make their annual migration from the Antarctic to this sheltered stretch of water between Isle Saint Marie and mainland Madagascar to calf, nurse their young, and find a mate.
Yeah, perfect, right here, bro. Look how beautiful this place looks, Kaza.
It looks absolutely stunning. Crazy.
Just beyond your head there, there's this little outcrop of rocks and palm trees. It looks glorious.
Like it's fake.
Yeah, it looks like a resort.
Yeah.
So we're at our new protected anchorage and we're gonna go in and see what the depth is like a bit closer to shore. Since we lost our depth sounder, we made one out of a dive rig. We're going old school. Okay.
So the charts are lining up pretty good. The depths as to what the charts say. We're in 4 meters of water. We're just gonna see how far tucked in we can get here. The closer we get, the more sheltered we are from the wind and the swell.
5 meters under the dinghy right here, 5 meters.
Copy that.
Yeah, I think we need to go a bit further off of the port bow, bro. So come in reverse out of here, because this one off the starboard bow is like shallow.
And I'll get the anchor ready.
Today is spa day on Delos. I just got my hair trimmed. Feeling fresh.
Do you feel like you're in good hands, Brian?
I've never gotten a haircut from Mr. Brady before.
Why are you laughing?
It's not a good sign. Fuck.
Karin!
What are you laughing? I don't know, bro. I'm looking for what she's laughing about, but I can't figure it out.
Is that okay?
I think you need to put some products in there, Brady.
Some products?
Yeah.
Like
hit him with the product.
Water. It smells like a fucking wet dog. Oh.
I have to go shower.
Oh, fuck!
brother, we got it going on tonight. We're all freshened up, haircuts, freshly made G&Ts. Camilla's got burgers going over here with homemade buns.
I wanna see if the G&T holds
homemade
up.
Oh, it's good, man.
It's good.
It's great.
And it's like a Delos double too.
It's fantastic. It's dangerous.
Up next.
This thing is coming for us.
Our bad weather has arrived.
The weather has finally cleared. It's sunny skies and the wind has gone away. This is what Madagascar is all about.
It's got a bunch of lines running off the port side into deeper water, far to ground.
Okay, sweet.
First thing in the morning. That's a wrap.
Like it?
I like it a lot.
I feel like I'm an explorer about to find a pirate ship.
I'm jumping out of my fucking skin here.
You're just about to come, Brion.